Vera. I'm the endocrinologist and a diabetologist. My main areas of interest are diabetes education and bone and mineral metabolic disorders. In our day-to-day practice, around 50% of our patients belong to the diabetes group, and the rest 50% of the patients are endocrine patients. And among the endocrine, we see more of thyroid disorders and polycystic ovaries, obesity problem, and bone and mineral metabolic disorders. What we have been seeing lately is the rising trend of obesity among the children, adolescents, and younger adults, and hence we are seeing more of metabolic problems at the younger age group. What we used to see earlier, say above 40 or 50 years of age. So right now we are seeing children at 15, 16 years of age with type 2 diabetes, with high blood pressure. And earlier there used to be the thought that if we are seeing a young person with high blood pressure, then there has to be some hormonal reason for the high blood pressure. But now it's just the other way around. It means mostly the lifestyle disorder which are pushing obesity, and hence also pushing the blood pressure and the sugars up, and we are seeing a lot of children with these metabolic problems at a younger age. Then the girls especially, we are seeing more of polycystic ovarian syndrome girls, which is again largely triggered by the bad lifestyle, their eating habits, high stress. That is also contributing to this metabolic problem. And what we are finding that the children are actually deviating from the conventional Indian cultural diet. They are more on junk food, fast food, and hence most of the good nutrients they are avoiding in the diet, and that in turn is also affecting their bone health, because the main nutrient to the bone is the calcium and the vitamin D, and they hardly drink any milk or curd or dairy product. They are not consuming these dairy products, and which in turn leads to bone health deficiency of the bone nutrient, which is largely the calcium and the vitamin D.